In this last part, we're going to apply the materials to our house. And we're going to look into setting up the light. If we start rendering our house by pressing F12, you see that the light is kind of weird. We have weird shadows, it's kind of dark here. So we're going to fix that. And what we're going to do is to switch to the top view with numpad 7. And then we see our light is over here. So when I select it with my left mouse button, you see here a light bulb. And that light bulb is the light properties of our lamp. So here you can say if you want a point light, a sun, a spotlight, or an area light. Well, we want a sun to fake the sun shining on our house, but it's from the wrong direction. So I'm pressing G to move and move it over here. R to rotate, but you can also drag this yellow dot like this. Now I press 3 to see the right side, and I see I'm shining a little bit over the house. So I want it in front of it, like this. And maybe I have to move it a little bit, but we'll see that if we render with F12 again. And now you see it's really, really bright. And that's because we have the strength of the light very high. So here it's 1000, which is a lot. So I change this to 1.5 and render again, so we can see if we have nice looking light. So it's a little bit dark, I can see here, so I increase it a little bit, maybe 2. And there's always a little bit tweaking with the light, so I leave it like this. And then we also see here there's some weird shadow going on. This should be a straight line here, and here it looks like the whole building is floating. So here in the shadow properties, we have this option here called contact shadow. So if I enable this, and I press F12 again to render, then you see that here there's a perfect straight line and here as well. So I close the render with the ESC key. So now we're going to look into materials. I'm going back to my 3D view with holding down my middle mouse key. And then we're going to select certain areas on this object and assign materials to it. So I select here my house, and here you this kind of sphere is the material panel. And you have two types of lists of material. This top list is the materials assigned to my object. And here this drop down view is all the materials of the whole scene. So this material is called material, which is a little bit weird because you don't want to have materials called material, but actually what they are. So I name this one white by double clicking on it. So the base color of the house is white, which is actually correct. But we're going to select the roof and add a red material to it. So what I'm going to do now is use tab to go into edit mode, 3 for face select. And then I see this was already selected. So I'm now going to select all the other faces like this. And there is a short key on the Mac. I don't know exactly the Windows key, but if you hold down the command key and you press a face, then you see it will select everything in between, which makes it a lot faster. If you make a mistake, for example, you click on this face, now you think, oh, my whole selection is gone. If you press command C or control Z, you have your whole selection back, which is pretty nice. So I'm rotating around the house, holding shift to select multiple faces. And here I also see the back of the roof needs to be selected. So now I have these in between, which I don't want. So I hold down shift, and if I press them again, I deselect everything. So now I just need to check here. Below here is another face, and here's another face. And I make this one and this one. So now I've selected the whole roof, and I want to assign a material to this. So what I'm going to do is create a new slot like this, and I select white, and I want to duplicate this one. So here is this tiny icon, press copy. Now it's called white 001. I double click to rename it to red. And now I'm going to change the base color to a red. You can choose any color you like. I'm going to create a red one, but you don't have to. So now I press here, assign. And what assign does is, like it says here in the tooltip, assign active material slot to selection. So now the red will be assigned to our roof. So I press assign. So I'm done now, but you don't see all the material colors. So what I'm going to do is change here the viewport shading. And if I press this one, you see actually the color of the materials. So the next step is to select the windows and to create a blue material for the windows. So I'm holding down shift and select these two faces over here. And we're going to do exactly the same. So I'm pressing here the plus sign. Select, you can now select red or white, whatever you want. I'm duplicating it. I call this one blue. And I change the color to a blue, like this. And now I press assign again. So now also these windows are blue. They look green, but if I deselect them, by just clicking on a face, you see they're actually blue. So another thing we need to do now is the door, which is a brown color. So I press the plus sign again, select now the blue, duplicate, rename it to brown, change the color to brown. Let's see where the brown is. Now you see this is it's kind of like orange but darker, so you can drag this to make it darker, and now we're getting some shade of brown. So I assign this to the door. So now if we render our image with F12, you can actually see that our house is already getting the nice colors. So one last thing is the grass. So I'm leaving object edit mode, switching back to object mode, and I select the grass here. So as you can see, there's no material assigned, and here we have all our predefined materials, but we don't have any because we want to have the grass, and it's not, there's no green material yet. So what I'm going to do is click here for a new slot, select, for example, the blue. And now we duplicate this one, double click, call it green. And now we give it a green color because that blue was really blue. I'll make it a little bit darker so it looks like grass. It's a kind of hard color, like this. So now if I render, you also see here the grass. But there's another, well, problem with the lighting. You see, the lighting here is pretty dark. So we're going to change that by changing the world properties. And here's your world. So what I'm going to do is change the strength and the color of the world, which is also emitting light. So I'm changing this to white, like this. And we make the strength 0.5 because it's pretty, I think it's pretty strong. So press F12. And then you see our house is nice lit. You have here a little bit shadow, but you see also the shadow is a lot smoother. So that's pretty nice. I'm going to save this as my house part 3. So now we're done setting up the material for our house, but we can go one step further to make it a little bit more like a real house, because here the windows are not set to a material here. So I don't even know the English word for this. We call it in Dutch, we call it vensterbank of kozijn. It's meer kozijn in Dutch, but I have to look it up. I don't know really the word. If you know the word, put it in the comments, because then I learn English as well. As you might know, I'm Dutch, so I don't know all the English words. Should have looked it up. So now I've selected the parts of the window. Now also for the door, I leave the bottom to have the house color, the concrete color. So now I've selected everything. And what I'm doing now is I'm going to the material panel, going to brown, and I have to assign them, because by assigning I change the material. So that's pretty nice. So I think if we render, also you can see the brown edges around the windows and around the door. So that concludes the third part of this tutorial. I've shown you some selection tricks where you use the command key on the Mac to select in between faces, and I also showed you how you can use the shift key to select and deselect faces. From the materials, you've learned how to assign materials to specific faces of an object, and you also learned how to copy materials. Don't forget to, after this tutorial, to look at the videos about the challenges. The challenges are videos where I only show you the example and I give you some hints how to create the example. But with the knowledge you've acquired in these tutorials, you should be able to create these. And there are two challenges. One is a simple challenge, which is using the same techniques, but looks also pretty similar to this first example we've made of this house. But the second one is more challenging, using more complicated shapes. And I'm not using any tricks. I'm using the same techniques, but it could be a little bit harder. If you have any questions, you can leave them in the comments. And in the description of this video, you find a link to more tutorials and the shortcuts I've used in this video. Good luck with the challenge, and I see you next time.